Welcome to my base.com. And since I try to keep it down in 8 grand to 10 minutes, if it goes over 10 minutes, I'm very fucking. That's what women do all the time. Important. And not important to liberals, libertards, people believe in God, people like the smoke, people like ayahuasca, people like DMT. They won't even get past the 14-second mark. Okay, because this message is not for the masses of asses. It's just pure, raw, cut footage. Because I'm a prodigy, motherfucker. Alright, I swear, I curse, I say all sorts of things that a lot of people may not like. Listener's discretion is advised. Listener's discretion is advised. As I said before, watch my Marthius Knowledge videos so you can prove my points. I make my own videos and shit like that because I'm truly alpha. Okay? I'm the guy who actually lost my virginity at the age of 30-something years old to a virgin wife, which is 8 years younger than I am. I have 2 daughters, okay? If you should already know. You follow me, you know I'm not your average hoe, which I'm not a hoe at all, okay? But a lot of females and people call me a hoe because my past. I can't be a hoe if I have never fucked a female who's not a virgin, okay? Strap-ons and dildos, you guys. Strap-ons and dildos. You get paid for them, okay? But let me talk about a subject here, in which, of course, I will refresh this again and again if I have to. Never bring foreign women into the States. Never bring women into, like, from Russia to any other country, because basically from the pimps, the pimpology, the style of the pimps, the true men in the world are the alpha males, the pimps, the gigolos, the hustlers, the escorters, which is me, right? So, don't bring them here because they do change. But if you do bring them here, you have to have a plan, like myself. You gotta have a plan to where she might try to trap you with alimony or child support. These bitches get really cocky and conceited, especially Ethiopian women. I know for a fact that the majority of motherfuckers who come here is gonna be looking at the word Ethiopian. I'm gonna actually put Brazilian women. I'm gonna tell you about right now how it works. I've talked to a lot of men. I told you through counseling and therapy sessions with all sorts of individuals of the rainbow. I may sound incoherent, but I'm telling the truth right now. 90%. I said 90%. Maybe 80, I'm being nice. I'm going to say 80 to 90% of women, when you bring them into the country and you give them the privileges, and you're a man, okay, you're a man. You brought her over here, okay? There's even a certain portion of men who getting killed. When they bring them over here, they end up getting either hurt or sued, okay, through child support or through the system. And this is where you have to plan out a strategy to make sure that doesn't happen, like I have, okay? So I already told you about my past already. I went to Ethiopia, lived out there for like 2 years, okay? Now, I told you, Ethiopians can't pay attention to me because I talk so fast. I talk very accurately and so fast, okay? And I get to the point. So, basically, I don't get to the point earlier because it's made intended to throw people off. But when Ethiopians get over here, I see so many videos on the internet. Oh, look, they talk so much, right? I know some guys know what I'm talking about. They talk like, and they get religious, don't they? They get real, real religious, right? Orthodox Christian and shit. They definitely change their tone of voice and their attitude when they get into the States. Okay? Especially if they were a black American male, okay? And they don't understand the difference between a black American male versus an Ethiopian. Statistics show that black males are basically bigger, have peaker penises, okay, in America. Okay, and I've talked to countless guys in Ethiopia. I told you before, I have friends who's out there who said it's very hard to get women, especially when you don't have any money. And that's sad. It's the women, just like in America. Women in America are far more worse, but the women in Ethiopia are much more nicer because they're living in poverty. And so from my experiences, by talking to a whole lot of women, which I do have video footage of, okay, I have video footage of talking to these women. They definitely would say, if they're truthful, they'll always say an African-American male is always more attractive than an Ethiopian male. But don't get mad. If any of y'all guys is fucking listening to me who live in Ethiopia, I'm not saying all of y'all guys. Okay, just show me a picture and I'll tell you what the rating numbers are. And, of course, there's a lot of African-Americans in this country, black Americans in this country. I live in the U.S. who are definitely taller than Ethiopians, hands down. And a lot of women, R. Kelly went over there. Okay, he went over to Ethiopia and shit. You know how many women flocked to him and shit, just want to see him? And Michael Jackson went over there. The most talented in the world are in America. The most diverse country in the world. And there will be some Ethiopians who will hate on me and speak to me in English. When I specifically told him, you better start learning your English. The most superior language in the world. The most international language in the world, right? You don't like that shit? That's a fact, right? But you speak to me in English. You're speaking to me in English. But anyway, the women change once they get over the country. So you already been warned thousands of times. If you just did your research before you go over there, I knew my wife would be changing. Everybody say, oh, you know, she's going to change, you know. So I bring her. Sometimes you'll see her on my videos. She got a little Swazi attitude, that little spunkiness and shit like that, little spicy shit. You know, and a lot of Ethiopian women, as a matter of fact, when they come over to the country, they still bring the old traditional shit from Ethiopia. I love their food. I love their flavors and everything like that, but it's not tender like it's supposed to be. There's a couple restaurants that can imitate the Ethiopian style of food and flavor, and it basically is hands down with the best, okay? But you have to understand that food is dated. Though it's more healthier to degree, spiciness and cayenne pepper and chili pepper is bomb, man. Their butter and shit, their milk and shit. I was there, motherfuckers. I was there, yes. But the whole point of this video is to tell you that if you ever have your woman laugh at you while you on the screen, because I saw this one couple together and shit, he's a black American and she's Ethiopian, Habesha and shit. I don't give a fuck what they call themselves. And she laughs at you while you're on the screen, she doesn't respect you deep down inside. Okay, dogs? Okay, because I know some guys is what's listening to me who have Ethiopian girlfriends, and they tend to laugh. Anytime, my wife never laughed at me when I was in Ethiopia. I lived in Ethiopia for 2 years, dogs. All right, I lived in Ethiopia for 2 years, and I had so much pussy out there. Looking at different types of pussy. I don't fuck used vaginas. Those women are not virgins out there. I keep saying this time and time again. Most of the women are not virgins. I only ask this question to women who I am attracted to. I say, are you a virgin? I usually say, so once she tells me she's not a virgin, she's useless to me. See, I lost my virginity to my wife, who was a virgin, who still lived with her father. And I got videos of all of that shit. Okay? I try to kill two birds with one stone by getting her sister too. But you know how bold I am as a real, true alpha to try to have two virgin pussies? That's fucking rare. That's motherfucking rare, man. Only I talk like this. But there'll be a lot of guys copying. But please understand, while I was in that country, so many women hit me up. But then you'll see women tell me, and guys who are haters, they'll say in my little comment section, which is all written, and I read everything before I post it, oh, you got burnt hurt. Dude, do you know who the fuck I am? I get paid by women who have used vaginas in America. Travel to your country and shit. Played basketball and football, and you're going to tell me I got butt hurt? That's how Ethiopian men are. They're like, but they're like little men. Because those Ethiopian bitches don't play. They ain't giving them no kind of play. They're not getting any play, and they don't play. If you ain't got no money to roll up or some shit like, no, they don't want you. And I'm not talking bad on Ethiopian men. I think I'd rather live in that country than living in America in certain ghetto areas. Because I lived in a lot of ghetto areas in America, right? And I'm like, shit, I tried to live out there. I brought my Xbox out. They didn't know what the fuck an Xbox was. They don't know what a fucking PS4 is. But the moral of what I'm saying here, before I can repeat myself time and time again, don't bring the misses over here unless you have a plan. Because I wanted my wife to try to take over shit, so I'm going to have no more responsibility. So when I try to file shit for her and get shit done, she's going to have to do everything herself, okay? I don't have, only responsibility I have is to watch my daughters. And my daughters is going to grow up correct, okay? Because my daughters going to understand what polygyny is, they're going to understand what sharing is, they're going to understand the values of a woman, they're going to understand that if you are religious, you got to follow that code. And women, overall, most women don't follow the patriarch of the Bible. They don't follow that shit. Okay, the LGBT don't follow that shit as well. They're not Christians. They're sinners, okay? But everybody want to fall back on Jesus. But when you got the real Jesus in front of you, they don't want to hear that shit, okay? I'm just trying to tell you what the real McCoy is, because I'm the real McCoy, right, motherfucker? I can prove it to you. I got countless niggas, fake niggas and shit, sensitive simp type niggas and shit on the internet trying to battle me and shit. You a pussy motherfucker, right? I always say, call nigga bitches and shit like that. We know we just calling people's names. We just see how strong a person is. That's how you can tell. If they want to fight you because they can't fight back with their words, they're a pussy. If they want to use a gun and they can't fight with the words, they're a pussy. If they want to defamate your character, defame your character because you just only call them a bitch, they're a pussy. It's basically that simple. It's not hard. But that's all I wanted to say, y'all brothers and sisters of Light and Dark, welcome to my page. It's not worth it. I'm going to post it down. I'm going to put all sorts of races there because I talked to a whole hundreds of them, including Russians, Brazilian women, Nigerians, Jamaicans, Barbarians, Trinidad. Yes, yes, yes. Only me. Because people want me to pick me up and put me on the radio show. I can't do it all. I got schizophrenia. Y'all should know that, right? Okay, I'm kind of sick, but I'm not. It doesn't mess with my mentos. It messes with my concentration. That's all it is. But my video game concentration and my dick concentration is pretty on par. All right, my education is on par. I'm no joke. I keep it simple. The only time it fucks with my schizoaffective mess with me is when I'm like, they just fuck with me in the throughout the day. Gotta put some headsets on and get to my medication, but that's about it. It's just noise. It's just noise. It's hard to concentrate sometimes. That's it. It doesn't help me with my cognitive thinking, okay? Because motherfuckers think they're better than me, and they're really not, okay? But I still get hits from Ethiopian men and women. I get some Ethiopians saying, you're cute, you got some like this. I say, yeah, if you really want to know what African features are, the white masters from old took the strongest niggas only, brought them over to Africa. This is why I say the strongest niggas are in America, right? They crossbreed them here in America. That's why they're worth $2 trillion. In the past, like in the 1940s, blacks were not allowed to play basketball. They weren't allowed to play football. They weren't allowed to play baseball, ya guys. Understand the history of America, please, and stop calling us you niggers and thinking that's going to offend us. Well, you don't even know what the term means. That's how Ethiopians are. They're conceited. They're prideful. They are broke. I'm not talking about all y'all Ethiopians now here. Please understand my English. Understand all my verbatim and understand my slang. Because I got a couple Ethiopians over there who back up what I'm saying easily. It's not a problem. Okay? Because I lived over there for 2 years. Hallelujah. But anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about, y'all guys. Okay? You can see my wife on my earlier videos in Marthius Nantes. Read my description box. And I hope y'all Ethiopians are starting to understand how to read. Because y'all don't like to read shit. A lot, even in America. No matter worldwide. People have low attention spans. And as I said before, most people are technically stupid, okay? So most people who watch me are pretty much stupid because I'll ask them a series of questions and they won't be able to answer it, okay? It's all about questioning techniques and introspective-wise. They don't do that correctly. But anyway, I'm about to go online. I told you I'm on Mixer and Twitch. I'm getting my camera in about a few days next week. Okay, you guys, my daughter's playing with her phone, okay? Okay, let me see. Love you all, but I hate the many of you. I love animals more than humans. Okay? And I really appreciate all the love I receive. So, peace. If you have any comments, questions, insults, or roast fest, you put it down below. And I answer all questions, even from my older videos. I make 500 videos per Marthius Nantes. Right now, I'm on Marthius Nantes 4. Okay, you can follow me. I feel the vibes, y'all. Feel the vibes. And people who jump to conclusions, get the fuck out of here. I don't like people who jump to conclusions. They get hurt the most. People are very sensitive, and they don't do any research. They don't even look at my past videos or anything. They change their minds, and they start joining. I never ask for any subscribers. If I go over 300,000 views, okay, per Marthius Knowledge, what do you think that means? Did I ask for subscribers? Did I ask for a like? No, I only ask for donations. That's much better than a liking it. I'm on at sporadic times here and there. You know, you can't keep track of me and shit because I got a schedule that's unstable. So you just got to catch me at the right time. I think that's better because I'm not ambitious, right? But anyway, peace and love to brothers and sisters. Don't like to welcome to the page. Follow me. Get some more knowledge. Get some real McCoy type shit. And y'all have a nice day. Peace.